Hello, welcome back to ASP.NET MVC tutorial. I am Ashish. So this is part 14 of this video series. Please watch part 13 in order to insert data into multiple tables. Okay, so now in this tutorial, I am going to discuss about how can you insert data into database using jQuery Ajax. Okay, so previously we were just saving our record by directly submitting a form. So the disadvantage was that it was just reloading my whole page. Okay, so now here we have an advantage with jQuery Ajax. So it's not going to reload your whole page. Instead, it will just refresh the small section of this web page. Okay, so let's have a look of it. Okay, so in the previous video, I have just created this method and which is going to save my data into multiple table. Okay, so in employee table as well as in site table, it's going to insert my data. Okay, so here in this method, I am not going to do any modification. Instead, I will just provide the data using jQuery Ajax. Okay, so let's come to the view, and here I have created this form in previous video. Let's have the view of it. Okay, so this is my drop down which is dynamically binded, and these are the text boxes. Okay, so let's remove the unwanted element. Okay, in order to make it clear. Okay, so let's also remove this and just use simple form. Okay, here you go. So here what you need exactly, you just need to know about the jQuery selectors and the Ajax. So jQuery selector is basically used to select the element, HTML element, and manipulate them. Okay, so I will just provide an ID to this form. Let's name is my form. Okay, and I will just select this element using this ID. Okay, so in jQuery you can access any element by having an ID, and if you have mentioned any class name, then you can also access this element with class name. Okay, so let's put a script tag and just okay, so everything you just need to start with the dollar document.ready. Okay, so if my DOM is ready, then I will just call this function. Okay, so inside this I will just write my whole method. Okay, so if this page is completely loaded, then only I can call this method, or I can just have the access of this. Okay, so second thing is that you just need to know about the Ajax. Okay, so Ajax means asynchronous JavaScript and XML. Okay, so it is basically used to get the data from the server and post the data to the server. Okay, so let's call the jQuery Ajax. So just use jQuery Ajax. Okay, and just write. Okay, the first you just need to use the type, so use post, and the second thing is that you just need first use the URL. So this is the URL you are going to call this and retrieve data or post data to that. Okay, so third thing is that you just need data. And fourth thing is that after success, okay, you are going to call a function and do that. And there are several parameters, but right now for this, for easiest things, I will just do this. Okay, so URL would be my test controller and my method name is index. Okay, and my data would be this form data. So I'm just going to use very simple thing like where data equals. So I'm going to select that form by its ID. So if I have provided the ID, then I need to put the hash sign and what is my ID. Okay, my form. Okay, and if I have given this class name like my form, then I need to use suppose dot my form. So in that way I can access this. Okay, so data my dot form dot serialize. Okay, so by using this line, it's going to give me the whole data, whole input data. Okay, so my serialized data would be in this data, and I will just paste it here. Okay, and after function I will just receive the response. So response would be anything if I am just sending it through controller. Okay, so I'm just using the alert message, you are done. Okay, so this is my basic URL, so my controller name and my method name, and before that the server name, it will automatically received from the server. Okay, so instead of using this submit type of submit, I will just use it button. Okay, and I will not need this. Okay, so I hope this is very clear to you, and let's run this project and let's see whether I will retrieve those data into this as a parameter. Okay, so here you go. So the main important point is that you just have the understanding how can you debug your code in jQuery. So press function F12 if you have a laptop. Okay, so here you can see the error. Okay, so dollar is not defined. So in jQuery, the placement of link is necessary. Okay, so it must be placed at the right place. Okay, so just control X jQuery reference and just put above the this script, because it's not understanding what is the dollar is, what is the dollar sign. Okay, so you just need, before that you just need to put this reference so that this code can understand that what is the dollar sign. Okay, and just save it and refresh this. Now this time you are not going to get this error. Okay, so I have just put this all the code into this document.ready, so that's why it was just showing me this alert message, means my form was posted. Okay, so I will just put it in on button click. So I will just use on click, or you can say I will just provide it on ID. Okay, so btn submit. So I have just given an ID to this, and okay, so dollar this hash, because I have just used an ID dot click, and on click I will just call a function, control z function. Okay, so now on button click this method will be fire. Okay, so put all thing in this and press control KD. Okay, and now just put a debugger here. Okay, so that you can analyze what data I am going to pass. Okay, so let's select the QA and let's any data name Ashish, and put address London, and site name whatever it may be, Google. Okay, so before that I will just put a breakpoint on my controller also, so that I can justify whether I am getting data or not. So just on clicking, just you can see the debugger. So press function F10. Okay, F10. So you can clearly see your data: department equals to name equal Ashish, address London. You can see, and on posting, just continue this. So in model you can just have the all address, means you can see the parameter address London, department 2, name Ashish, site name is Google. So you have just provided all data using a JAX, and this code is going to save my data. Okay, so let's see, here I have just 8 records. Now let's continue this. Okay, so you are done, means the data has been saved. Okay, now let's refresh this database and execute this. Okay, so I have my 10th record. Even 7th record was null null null, 8th record was Ashish to London. Okay, so in this way you can just call the Ajax method and save your form. Okay, so here one thing I need to do, I want to just clear my form. So you just need to do one step. Just use, instead of button, just use reset, type equal to reset. So just, it will just save my form. And before that, on loading, okay, so I will just use a div here, okay, and I will just show the loader. Okay, so I will just use this loader here. Okay, so inside div I am going to use this loader, so that I can clearly see the form has been submitted by jQuery. Okay, so let's give a width equals 150 and div, and let's give a style. Okay, text align center. Okay, so here you can see, now refresh this. Okay, so here is your loader. Okay, so in first step you will just hide it. Okay, so display equals none. Okay, so right now I have just hidden this. I can roll F5, and now after clicking on submit button I want to show this. And again, after completion of AJAX call, I want to just show it and just hide it again. Okay, so let's give this an ID. Okay, so I will just give an ID equal to loader diff. Okay, and copy. And when I click on submit button, then I just need to show this. So hide just div dot show, and just copy this, and after completion of this I will just hide it. Okay, so about the jQuery features we will discuss in later video session in detail. Okay, so jQuery is a powerful client-side scripting language. Okay, so let's name is Sarah, address New York, site name Google. Okay, so I'm now going to submit this form. So I have just placed this debugger here. Okay, so now here you can see the loader, and if I just complete this AJAX call, then you are done. Okay, so my loader has been hided. Okay, so in this way you can make a AJAX call and you can save your data. Okay, so in later video session we will discuss about the basic things of jQuery, like it has many features. It has many we will discuss about the selectors and the effects like slide up, slide down, show, hide, and much more things. Okay, so that's it. Thank you very much for watching my tutorial, and if you really like, then give us a thumbs up. Please subscribe my channel Aapka Nigam, and visit our official page, that is facebook.com/technotipstutorial, and if you have any query, then please comment, and of course share my videos. Okay, thank you very much. Bye bye, have a great day.